Welcome to a lesson on how to use the TI84 graphing calculator to find the probability of a data value being below and above a given z-score in a normal distribution, and also how to find the probability of a data value being between two z-scores of a normal distribution. So for our first example, we want to find the probability of a randomly selected data value from a normal distribution having a z-score below 1.4, meaning the probability that z is less than 1.4 and the probability that the z-score would be above 1.4, given here as a probability of z greater than 1.4. Remember, if z equals 1.4, the data value would be 1.4 standard deviations above the mean. So this is the standard normal distribution. Let's say z equals 1.4 is somewhere in here. The area to the left would represent the probability that z is less than 1.4. And the area to the right would be the probability that z is greater than 1.4. And the area would represent the probabilities that we're looking for. So instead of using the z-score table, we can use a TI84 graphing calculator to determine these probabilities. Where if we use the normal CDF feature, then enter a comma b comma mu comma sigma, this gives the values of the cumulative normal density function occurring between x equals a and x equals b. This would be the cumulative area under the standard normal distribution. But in our case, if mu and sigma are not specified, then mu equals 0 and sigma equals 1, and therefore a and b would be the lower bound and upper bound z-scores. So because we already have the z-score, we will leave off mu, the mean, and sigma, the standard deviation. But notice how we do have to have a lower and upper bound z-score. 1.4 would be the upper bound z-score. For the lower bound, we'll have to make this up. We know if z was equal to -3, that would be almost all the entire data. So we'll exaggerate the lower bound z-score and use something very, very small. So to begin, we'll press second vars for distribution, option 2 for normal CDF. We'll first enter our exaggerated lower bound z-score. Let's use -99,999, comma, the upper bound z-score, which we know is 1.4, close parenthesis, and enter. This gives us a cumulative area to the left where z is less than 1.4. So to four decimal places, the probability that z is less than 1.4 would be approximately 0.9192. And therefore, the probability that z is greater than 1.4 would be 1 minus 0.9192, or 0.0808. Let's take a look at a second example. Here we want to find the probability of a randomly selected data value from a normal distribution having a z-score between 0.5 and 2.1, which we can express in this way here. So if this is a standard normal distribution, the lower bound z-score would be -0.5, let's just say somewhere in here. The upper bound z-score would be z equals 2.1, let's just say somewhere in here. So this probability would be equal to the area bounded by these two z-scores. And we can quickly determine this area, which would be our probability, using the TI84. Again, we'll press second vars for distribution, option 2, and now enter the two z-scores. The lower bound z-score is -0.5, comma, the upper bound z-score is 2.1. Again, because we have the z-scores, we're leaving off mu and sigma, so we need a close parenthesis and enter. The probability that z is between -0.5 and 2.1 is approximately 0.673. 3/6. I hope you found this helpful.